Welcome everyone. In this video, I am going to discuss standard loci of complex number. Standard loci of complex number. So, if we are able to remember some formulae, then we can directly find the loci within few seconds. But you have to remember some standard result. Now, result number 1, mod z minus z1 plus mod z minus z2 equals to 2k, where k is constant, represents an ellipse having z1 and z2 at the foci if 2k greater than mod z1 minus z2. So try to recall, this is result of coordinate geometry. S dash, if p moves such that sp plus s dash p equals to constant, then we say locus of p, this figure is ellipse. So z minus z1, z is variable. Z1 is at one focus. So z minus z1 is sp. If this is z1 and it is z2. So z minus z1 modulus, this is sp. Z minus z2 modulus s dash p equals to constant. Then it represents ellipse if 2k greater than z1 minus z2. And if 2k equals to z1 plus z2, it represents line segment. And if 2k less than z1 minus z2, then we do not get any real loci. You may get equation involving x and y, but center, suppose foci, they are of imaginary. So you cannot draw it. That is no real loci. So look, application. Z plus 1 plus z minus 4 equals to 4, then locus of z is. So look, if we compare it from result number 1, so z1 equals to 1 and z2 equals to 4, z1 equals to minus 1 and z2 equals to 4. So mod of z1 minus z2 equals to 5. Now what is 2k? 2k equals to 2k. 2k equals to 4. 2k. So z1 minus z2 greater than 2k. Z1 minus z2 greater than 2k. So it represents an ellipse. So if you remember this result, you can tick the option within a second. Now look for the problem number 2, application. Z plus mod z minus 4 equals to 4, then locus of z. So look here, z1 equals to 0 and z2 equals to 4. So z1 minus z2 equals to 4. So 2k is 4. So this equals to 2k. So if it is 2k, it represents line segment. Look, it represents line segment. Why it is line segment? Suppose this is z equals to 0, 4. So it lies within this range. So this is line segment. Now we consider result number 2. Now look, second standard result, z minus z1 minus z minus z2 equals to 2k. K is constant, represents an hyperbola having z1 and z2 at foci if 2k less than z1 minus z2. Here it is 2k less than. If 2k equals to z1 minus z2, it represents line break. And if 2k greater than z1 minus z2, no real loci. No real locus. Suppose no real locus. So look, same. So two fixed point, S and S dash, and P is moving point. So look, this is result of coordinate geometry. This is z1, this is z2. So sp minus s dash p, this mod, is difference of distance. We know this results of hyperbola. SP minus S dash P equals to 2K. Then locus of P is hyperbola. This is our standard result of hyperbola. So similar like, look, Z minus Z1, Z minus Z2 equals to 2K. 2K less than this, then it represent hyperbola. 2K equals to this, it is a break. Look, hyperbola, two parts. So there is no part here. We get a straight line like that, this to this and this to this. So break point. This is called represent line break. Now application. Look, difference means mod. That is why we are taking mod. It SP or S dash P. Anyone is greater than the other. So Z plus 2. So what is Z? Z1 equals to problem number 1. Z1 equals to minus 2. Z2 equals to 2. What is mod Z1 minus Z2? This is 4. And what is 2K? 2K equals to 2K equals to 3. 2K equals to 3. And mod Z1 minus Z2. Z1 minus Z2. So this is minus 2. This. So Z1 minus Z2. Z1 minus Z2 is 4. And 2K equals to 3. 2K equals to 3. So Z1 minus Z2. Z1 minus Z2. This is less than. So look, 2k, 2k is 3 and z1 minus z2 is 4. So 2k, 2k is 3, 2k is 3, z1 minus z2 is 4. So 2k less than 4. So this condition is satisfied. So it represents hyperbola. So whenever it is given in difference form, we think that it should be hyperbola. But look, then you look whether these conditions are satisfied or not. If 2k less than this, then you are sure that it is hyperbola. Now look, for the problem number 2, look, here also it is given in difference form. This will be difference. This will be in difference form. So you may think this is hyperbola, but look, more conditions are given. So what is Z1? Z1 equals to minus 2. Z2 equals to 2. So mod Z1 minus Z2 equals to 4. So what is 2K? 2K equals to 4. So this condition is satisfied. So it represents a line break. It represents a line break. So look, difference means hyperbola. If 2k less than z1 minus z2. If 2k equals to this, it is not hyperbola, it is a line break. If 2k greater than this, no real locus. Next, look, the standard result 3. So look, if Z minus Z1 by Z minus Z2 equals to K, where K is constant, modulus of this, then if K not equals to 1, then locus is a circle. Locus is a circle. So when K is equal to 1, what will be the locus? I will discuss it later in case number 4. So if K not equals to 1, then it represents a circle. Number 2. If Z minus Z1 whole square plus Z minus Z2 whole square equals to mod Z1 minus mod Z2 whole square, then locus of Z is a circle having Z1 and Z2 as endpoints of diameter. For circle, there are four possible cases. Look, number C. If Z minus Z1 whole square plus Z minus Z2 whole square equals to K, where half of Z1 minus Z2 whole square less than K, then it also represents a circle. And number 4, argument of Z1 minus Z2 by Z minus Z2 equals to plus minus pi by 2. Then locus is a circle with Z1 and Z2 as endpoints of diameter. So you have to recall this result. if you are able to remember these results, then you can find the answer, that is locus, in a second. So look, application. Number one, z plus 2i by z minus 4i, total mod equals to 3. Then what is locus of z? So look, here it is constant k. K is not equals to 3. So obviously, it is circle. It is circle. Number two, look, if 2z minus 1 by z plus 1 equals to m represents a circle, then mod, then m, what is the condition regarding m? So look, if we compare it with problem number 3, then look, in both cases coefficient of z is 1. So we put first it in standard form. So z minus half, this is 2, by z plus 1 equals to m, or z minus half by z plus 1 equals to m by 2. This is 2 at the denominator. So it will represent a circle if, what is the condition? M by 2, k equals to m by 2. So m by 2 not equals to 1, that is m not equals to minus 2. So what is answer? M not equals to minus 2. Then application 3. Argument of z minus I by z plus 3i equals to pi by 2. Then locus of z, z is complex number, x plus iy. What is the locus? So look the standard result. Z minus z1 by z minus z2 argument equals to plus minus pi by 2. So here it is pi by 2. So locus is obviously circle. So this is the advantage. If you know the standard result, you can write the answer within a second. Now look, one more case for locus of circle. So problem number 3, z minus 1 by z plus 1 equals to purely imaginary. Then locus of z is a circle, straight line, ellipse, none. So we have already discussed, if z minus 1 by z plus 1 is purely imaginary, then it lies on y-axis, negative or positive. So in this case, argument of z1 by z2 equals to plus minus pi by 2. So it is given in twisted form. So if this one is purely imaginary, that is, it lies on imaginary axis. So here pi by 2, if it is here, minus pi by 2. So it represents circle. Now, case number 4. So look. If z minus z1, we have considered these cases, z minus z1, z minus z2 equals to k. If k not equals to 1, then it is circle. If k equals to 1, so this reduces to this equation, z minus z1 equals to z minus z2. Then locus is bisector of the line segment joining z1 and z2, bisector of the line segment. Number two, if z plus z bar plus z minus z bar equals to k constant, then locus of z is a square. And number c, equation of line joining z1 and z2, z equals to tz1 plus 1 minus t into z2, t belongs to bar, or z1 bar 1, z2 bar 1 equals to 0. Now application. So look, problem number 1. So look, z plus z bar, z minus z bar equals to 8. So it is of case number B. So it represents, suppose z plus I, and z minus I. So z plus i, z minus i equals to 8. It is its conjugate. Then it represents a square. It represents a square. Suppose it is 2 plus 3i and it is 2 minus 3i. So z plus z1, this is z1, z minus z bar equals to 8. Then it represents a square. So recall this legend. Now problem number 2, z plus 2 minus 3i, z minus 5 minus 2i. So look, this by this equals to k equals to 1. So it is not circle. So it is, you know, from this result. So perpendicular bisector of the line segment joining 2 plus 3i with negative sign. So minus 2 plus 3i and 5 minus 2i. And finally, if you write, if area of triangle joining z plus iz and iz is 50 square unit, then mod z equals, so z, so look, z means x plus iy, so z plus iz, so x plus iy plus I into x plus iy, so minus, so x minus y plus I common x plus y. So if we write it in order pair, we get this one. And what is z? If you write it in order pair, xy. And finally, iz, so I into x plus iy, so ix minus y, so minus y plus ix, so point is minus yx. So what is delta? You know, half of xy1, x minus y, x plus y1, and minus y, x1, equals to, it is given 50. So you simplify, so x into x plus y minus x, so y minus y into x minus y plus y, and 1 into x square minus xy, x square minus xy plus xy plus y square, so equals to 100. Plus minus 100 you can take. So xy cancel. So this is minus y square and this is plus y square. xy cancel. So this is minus xy plus yy cancel. yy cancel. So minus xy plus x square plus xy plus y square equals to 50. So x square plus y square equals to, so not 50, this is 100. X square plus y square equals to 100. This is mod z whole square equals to 100. So mod z equals to 10. So mod z equals to 10. So look. So if we are able to recall this standard form of loci, we can solve multiple type question within a second. So it is not difficult to remember, but if you make practice, it will not very difficult. So this is video relating complex number. This is of part 2. So in the next video, we shall consider problems of JEE Main and rotational problem regarding argument in the next classes. So thank you.